at the start line in Eilat, and Richard hasn't actually seen this yet, so this is really cool that we get to come and check it out.
That's the marker.
That's it. That's the thing that's going to be guiding him through, along with all the maps, of course. And tomorrow we start at 6 o'clock on the dot, and we've got some local runners coming to join Rich for the first 10Ks. And 6:12 is the official sunrise, but that means the sun's going to be up a bit before 6, so we should have some really beautiful light.
I consider it hard compared to what I heard that Richard does.
It's really hard for the muscles. I know they try it because I'm from the place.
Oh, he's an amazing runner and he's an inspiration to us all. And you know, I bet he's inspiring so many people around the world. As runners, we really appreciate the fact he's here and would love, you know, to see him here again.
He runs, he pushes it. Yeah, it's great.
What we did so far was, I'd say, pretty hard. Some steep walls and climbing to do. We were running with a dog as well, so we had to lift him up some stairs and walls on the way. So that wasn't that easy, but made it so wonderful. What a morning, what a great way to spend early morning.
וכן, כיף לראות אורחים, כיף שהם מכירים את הארץ שלנו, שהם רואים שזה לא מלחמות רק, ודברים ערבים, וארץ מקסימה עם אנשים מקסימים, שיבואו.
Saying that it's good and it's beautiful that people will come here and see Israel the way it is and not the way that sometimes it's been presented through the media. The people here are not all about wars and not all about fighting. They're good people here. And it's good that they come and meet and like present it and show it to the other world when they get back to wherever they came from.
War is war. Lift your hands to warm the sun.
Well, I think it's very amazing that someone is making his own challenges in their life, and he's doing the Shvil, and he managed to take it for himself.
War is war.